Hello ladies and gentlemen, my name is Brenttime, and today I'm going to show you how to make a Grav dedicated server. All the information in this video will be provided from the grav.wikia.com page with a link in the video description below. So if you would want to see this page to have on your second monitor or have side by side while you're doing this and watching this video, you will have that available. Okay, so first things first, we're actually going to have to make a batch file or a .bat file in order to start the server because there's no actual dedicated support via an exe. So, first, go to your Steam library, find Grav in there. If you have this as a pirated copy, I cannot help you, I'm sorry, you're going to have to find a different video. So, this is a legit copy of the game. So first we're going to go to the library, find Grav. We're going to right click it, go down to the last option, which is properties. Then we're going to go to the third tab in, which is local files. From there we're going to hit browse local files. And if I'm going too fast, please do pause the video while I'm doing this. So next, you're going to hit double click binaries, double click Win32. This does not work in the Windows 64 currently. I don't know if there's going to be support added or what, but currently it does not work. Alright, from here you're going to want to right click, hit new, text document. I'm going to name this server. I'm going to name it in all caps, that way I can see it a lot easier. Actually, I'm going to name it a server. Oh, whoops. Sorry about that. I'm going to name it a server because then through the... I'm going to name it AA server, apparently. Through the dialog, it'll, from the actual folders, because it's in alphabetical order, it'll start from the top, which is awesome. Okay, from here, once you have the text document, I'm going to right-click and hit edit. You can also double-click it. Once you do that, it will come up in Notepad. Don't worry, this will become a batch file in less than no time. So, what we're going to do from here is we're actually going to start to add the actual support for the server. So, in here, we're going to copy and paste this, which will be in the video description below, or it's on the Wikia page that I have also left a link in the description below. And from here, all you're going to do is you're going to find the certain options that you would like. So we're going to look at the server name, and we're going to name this Brenttime's server. For example, you can name it whatever you want. Once you have that, you're all good here. You can actually hit Control S, then File, Save As. All you got to do from here is type .bat, and it is now a .bat file. Now, to edit this now, you're going to actually have to right-click and hit Edit, and you can actually re-edit in Notepad. But if you wanted to actually add a password to the extension or add PVE, I'm actually going to show you that right now. So, to add PVE and no PVP, all you gotta do is at the end of MaxPlayers 64, which we're actually gonna tone down to MaxPlayers 20. At the end of this, after the question mark, we're just going to type allowpvp equals 0. And then you're also gonna put another question mark after that. And that will make it a PVE only server. I do not like that, so I'm going to get rid of that and hit Control S. There is a second option if you would like to have it be a password protected server. From here, all you've got to do is go to the end of server name at the quotation end of the quotation, make a question mark, then type game password equals, and then just whatever phrase you want. So I'm going to say 123. This is if you want a server where only your friends can join. So if that's really what you want, that's all you got to do there. Again, I'm not going to do that because that's not what I want. So now I'm back at that. I'm going to go ahead and close it. Now I can actually launch the server. The server will launch in the dialog box right here. And as it loads, we're actually going to go ahead and start my game. So while the server is launching, the game will start, and once the game comes up, which it should in a couple seconds, we're going to hit tab. And we're going to type, let me just make sure I have the correct thing before I make an ass out of myself. Okay. Yep. All right. Just making sure. We're going to hit tab, and then we're going to type open 127.0.0, and then that should come up. And actually, it should be a default port or not. Let's go ahead and retype that. OPEN space 127.0.0.1:7785, and then hit enter. Now apparently we should see a lot of activity going on in our dedicated server, which we do. We're just waiting a little bit more. I don't know if I can see my server on here. While this server takes its time to load up, I'm going to pause the video for you. Real quickly, guys, I just remembered this actually. This will not be the case for my server, but just in case your server actually has a problem going onto the server browser, I'm actually going to help you right now. So first things first, actually go down here, we're going to actually do something even a little bit more different. Hit the Windows key and R at the same time. You'll run your run. It'll be Windows run, basically. Type cmd. Type ipconfig. And you're looking at the default gateway, 10.0.0.1. Yours might be 192.168.1.1 or 192.168.2.1. So from there, all you're going to do is type in your default gateway, mine being that. And you're going to log into your router. From there, you're going to find your advanced tab or some other tab, something that will relate to port forwarding. Once you get there, you're going to hit add service, add exception, blah, 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 blah. This is getting behind your firewall for your router. We're going to name the service Grav, and it's going to be TCP and UDP. We're going to use this IPv4 address, which is actually our computer's address to our router. We're going to use that right there. Mine's 12. And then we're going to type in the following port, 7785, 7785 for both the starting and ending ports. Once you add that, now the server can get through your firewall, just in case you have a firewall that's going on. If you run into any other firewall issues, it actually might be a Windows firewall thing. So from there, you either have to go through your antivirus, mine being AVG, or Windows firewall, which you can find in a different video on the internet. So, now we wait while the server goes. Alright guys, so the server actually crashed on me, so I can't really show you the actual in-game things, but it did work. I got actually to the game, and then I was playing, and then it crashed. And that was because the game, not the server. The server is actually still up and doing fine. Actually, the server is not up doing fine. The server got shut down when I had to actually close the window and sign out of my Windows account because the game was not clearing from my screen. And so the server's working fine. I had one of my friends connect, and he said everything was good. And the next question is, how do you get friends connect? And all you got to do, and I'll have a link in the video description below, you can either go on Google and type in what's my IP, or you can go to whatsmyip.com, which I'll put whatsmyip.com in the video description below. You do not want to show this to anyone that is not a friend, because they can mess with you. And yeah. So guys, that ends my tutorial. I hope you know how to make a server now. And yeah, I'll see you guys in the next one then. And go ahead and hit a annotation in the video now to go to another video. And yeah, I'll see you guys next time.